We didn't make this rack because we needed additional business right now. We made it to help people. So if we're going to help people, let people help people. So their money and their dollars and 100% of the proceeds, and so a good portion of their dollars are going to fight the cause of this keeping everyone at home to start with.
You're listening to Barbell Logic, brought to you by Barbell Logic Online Coaching, where each week we take a systematic walk through strength training and the refining power of voluntary hardship. Welcome to the Barbell Logic Podcast. This is Matt Reynolds, and I am here today with a special guest, Bert Sorin, who is the, I don't know, president, CEO, all things at Sorinex. At Sorinex.com. A lot of you, most of our listeners will know about Sorinex. Sorinex is it's really a high-end custom. They make amazing equipment. You guys have seen our good buddy Coop from Garage Gym Reviews talk about them a lot. Brett McKay, I think, has had you on the podcast, on the Art of Manliness podcast in the past. Sorinex was started by your dad a long time ago, before we had this massive explosion of all of the equipment manufacturers. You guys were one of the first, so...
Yeah. Thanks for having me, first of all. So, Sorinex was started as a pet project by my dad, who was always into lifting and to building and making solutions better. And the equipment that was currently at that time in the late 70s that was on the market just wasn't good enough. It wasn't either adjustable enough, strong enough, or worked in the way that he wanted. He's a big guy. He's 6'5", probably 250 at the time. And it just, the stuff wasn't built for a large athlete at the time. So he said, I could build it better. So went out of the garage and started.
Your dad always looked to me, I remember when I was a kid in, you know, high school and college, your dad always looked to me like the consummate strength coach. Like he looked like a Division I strength coach, right? So big dude, barrel chest, shorty shorts.
Right. Yeah. It's kind of like a combination between Pizarenko and Tom Selleck.
That's right.
Yeah, which is not a bad look.
No, it's awesome. So, and then what I always knew about Sorinex was, I think I felt like, and this may not even be entirely fair, but certainly back in the day, you know, in the late 90s, early 2000s, Sorinex was like it was the best equipment for university gyms, Division I, pro. It was that kind of thing. A lot of like the best high end commercial quality stuff. And I think you guys still do a lot of that, but you've now branched out, especially with the growth of the home gym market. You guys have branched out into the custom home gym market, and also still provide, you are the high quality. Like, we all kind of know about those lower quality guys that make their stuff in China and whatnot, and you're trying to pay the cheap rate. Sorinex is on the other end, and you guys are the premium end of the equipment side. Is that fair?
Yeah, that's fair. And I appreciate that. Thank you. But yeah, you're exactly right. We started really our business. Yeah, there were some local high schools and things like that that we were doing. But by the mid 80s, we were doing full custom builds for universities like Kentucky and Tennessee and, you know, for their football programs. And that's where we made our name in the human performance world. So things had to be bigger, had to be stronger, had to be more adjustable, because that was the athlete level that we were working with, where, you know, University of Tennessee in the mid 80s and 90s, you know, a 400-pound bench isn't extraordinary, and they're going to do it all day long. And a bench has to be able to take that kind of pounding. So that's where we've always been. And we've always done home gyms. It's not like we still don't, I guess we see it now. There is a home gym market, but before it was just, do people want really good stuff in their house? And if you do, like, let's say Garth Brooks in the 1990s, he had a home gym from us, and regular people too. So we've always sold to homes. It's just we've kind of been under the radar as the go-to guys for the go-to guys. So we're just not as widely known, I guess, up until somewhat recently.
And I think it's a difference between, you know, sometimes you want to go out and you want to eat filet mignon or a nice ribeye, and that's Sorinex. And then there are other places that are the dollar double cheeseburgers. And you might, and that's, you know, it's probably higher quantity, higher quantity, lower quality, cheaper. And for, you know, broke college kids, those things are fine. Ultimately, I think there are so many people, we would just want to get people training, right? So getting people training is the key. The reason I wanted to have you on the podcast is because yesterday you made a post, today's Saturday, this podcast will go up on Monday, yesterday on Friday, you made a post about a new rack that you guys are offering, the off-the-grid rack, which is not your typical rack that you guys offer. And I love the message. And so I wanted to talk to you a little bit about this. It was this idea of, first off, if for those of our listeners, I'm sure many of them have gone on the equipment manufacturers, there isn't much out there, right? So demand has outstripped supply tremendously. There are very few racks available. There's very little equipment available right now. The turnaround time is long. A lot of these equipment manufacturers have even shut down their websites for a week or 2 weeks to kind of fill the back orders. And so you came out yesterday. I loved it. You were out in the woods, surrounded by pine trees, and you had this off-the-grid rack mounted to a couple trees in the woods. And you told people, like, hey, we know we need, like, what can we do? We're equipment manufacturers. And I don't want to steal your story. I want you to be able to tell the story, but it was like, hey, how can we provide quick, cheap, solid equipment to people who need it right now? And then the best part about it was you said, like, we're going to take our profits from this thing and we're going to donate them to the fight against COVID-19. And so I wanted to have you on the show and talk about it because, one, our clients need it. Our listeners need this because many people have reached out, like, we can't find any equipment. And you guys have filled a need there. And then I love it that rather than preying on the fact that demand is so high and supply is so low, you were like, look, we're just going to take our profits and we're actually going to donate them to the fight right here. So I love it. That's why I wanted to have you on the show. So tell us a little bit about how that came about.
I appreciate it. I guess, you know, the thing is we've been extremely blessed in our business. We have some military contracts right now that are certainly paying the bills. We've been deemed necessary and essential by the U.S. government to stay going because we have giant contracts to fulfill for the Army, for the ACFT. That's the Army Combat Fitness Test that mm-hmm. you may have heard about.
Yeah.
So we're rolling and rolling hard. University orders are pouring in left and right. I mean, we're doing okay. But that all being said, those are all business. Those are all orders that have a 8, 10, 12 week lead time, which has been more specific, more dialed for our business model. So, of course, when this thing kicked off, gyms started closing. My phone and all my sales guys' phones are blowing up from really a lot of our college and pro clients saying, you know, we're the Houston Texans. We're shutting down. My guys need something to train on. And, you know, I'm just using them as an example. But it was happening left and right, to the point where we started looking through old scratch and dent trailers, anything that we had there was a demo unit and, you know, bumpers that mismatched, like anything we could get people. And of course that goes super fast.
Sure.
And so I got talking to this was last Wednesday. I got talking to my, the guy that runs in my shop, and I said, all right, well, let's get X number, you know, squat stands going. Squat stands ought to something we could get through the shop fast. He's like, Bert, like, we're down welders right now. We're down prefab right now. We're already slammed at the tilt, what we could get out the door, adding something else that we don't know we have clients for right now when we're shorthanded isn't an option. I said, well, we have all these guys needing gear. And we kind of laughed. He goes, all right, we'll come up with something that doesn't need human hands to touch it right now. We can figure it out. And so, you know, I was here in the cave, like we're podcasting right now. So I was at the house, a little home gym. I started sketching out some things that would work. I FaceTimed my design manager there at work, said, hey, hop on a FaceTime with me, showed him what I was thinking. He got it right away. Probably 20 minutes later, he had a drawing of it, sends it over. Yep, let's do it. The next morning, it was cut out, bent. It was put in my marketing manager's house literally that day. So within 24 hours, we had a prototype working. Tweaked it, tried a couple things over the weekend, and of Monday we made 50 of them, and we've already sold about four times that many in the first day of launching it on Friday. And the idea of it was, let's get something that we could get through the shop super fast that doesn't need a bunch of additional labor, and people could get them. My goal is for people to have them ship from our location in 3 to 5 business days versus 8 or 10 weeks or whatever it may be. Hey, if I sell 1,000 next week, I'm sorry, it's probably going to be a little longer, but sure, we're doing what we can. We've literally changed our whole model. Not that we need to, believe me, we have enough stuff to do, but I hated hearing all these coaches talk about and home gym guys talk about, hey, this kid's going into his senior year he's been training his, you know, for the last 10 years to be ready for this. And all the gains we got this year are going to be lost. And yes, can people buy kettlebells and bands? Sure. We've sold out of basically kettlebells and bands, but you have to axial load at some point if you're going to be a big, strong, powerful athlete. So a rack was obviously what we needed to do. So we designed this rack and we said, okay, let's put it at a price point that anyone could afford, or most people can afford, or at least more people could afford than normal. $349, no glitz, no glamour in there. And we looked all over the country. We figured we could ship it for $100 everywhere, for 48 states. So that'll save some people some money. You have an additional $100 if you want to get plastic protection on it. So you're, you know, for a little over, right around $500, you're out the door, and it can be that week. And then we started looking at different discounting structures, and we just said, hold on a second. Like, we didn't make this rack because we needed additional business right now. We made it to help people. So if we're going to help people, let people help people. So their money and their dollars and 100% of their, you know, the proceeds. And so a good portion of their dollars are going to fight the cause of this, keeping everyone at home to start with.
Yeah.
And we're just kind of a conduit to help people get what they need to do. So, I mean, Sorinex has always been a solutions-based company. We pride ourselves in driving forward the industry with new innovative solutions. This is kind of, I believe, one of them. And it doesn't look like a normal Sorinex piece with all the bells and whistles and high-end and super Gucci, but as I kind of said in that video, it's a wartime rack for a wartime scenario. I mean, it's not the coolest thing we've ever made or the most bad A, but you know, to hold a bar off the ground, it's going to be strong. And, you know, let's be really honest. If 3 days a week you do front squats and pull-ups, you're probably not going to be in bad shape.
That's right. Yeah, it allows you to do squats. It allows you to do presses. It allows you to do bench presses, which is, of course, when you deadlift off the floor. I love the rack. It's two different, it's two separate vertical pieces and can mount to your garage wall on some studs. You can mount it, like I said on the video, you mounted it to a couple trees. Basically, anything that's sturdy, you can put these vertical mounts on. And because it's two separate pieces, you can actually adjust the width. You've got some flexibility there in the width. Whether, you know, if you're a great big guy and you need to take a grip on the squat on a bar that goes all the way out to the collars, you can make the width a little narrower for the rack. If you're somebody that takes more of a closer grip, it's wider. You can set the rack at a point just inside the collar. So you've got some flexibility there. And then you've really thought through little things like the, you know, you've got a spot up at the top so that you can throw your barbell in a spot on top of this rack, and you can do pull-ups from the barbell, so it gives you an option to do pull-ups or chin-ups. You've got all kinds of little things like that, things that'll hold carabiners, like lots of little, you've thought about this. Even though this is a sort of a machine-made rack, right? I assume it's just, you know, is it water jet and bent?
We laser it, bend it,
yeah,
powder.
And it's golden, which is awesome. You've still really thought through some of those functional pieces of this thing to make it as functional as it possibly could for being one of your lower end racks. And I love it.
Oh, well, thanks. The funny thing is that we call the peak system, the drop in where you could take your Olympic bar and drop it into the top for a chin up bar. That was something I used probably 17, 18 years ago in a pair of squat stands with a little welded V on top to drop your Olympic bar so you could do chins. It never took off before its time, whatever. And so we started looking at this rack and we said, okay, well, we're going to need to have a chin station, but we didn't want to have to weld anything.
Sure.
And so how do you even if you have a less expensive chin bar, you still have to have the flanges welded and then you have bolts and then that drives up the cost for more. And we go, hold on. If they got a rack, that means they have a bar. If they have a bar, put it on top. There's your chin bar. It's knurled. Beautiful. It's nice. You're ready to roll. And it gives you a place to store it if you need. So it, you know, sometimes remembering things that worked in the past kind of come back to help you out.
Absolutely. If I remember right, it sticks out of the wall just like 13 and a half inches, something like that, right?
That was right. Yeah. We just wanted to make sure when you rack a bar, you still had at least a hand width in between the plate and the wall. So you, you know, don't smash your hand, but then also, you know, as you walk in, you have space for your face. Is it a little close when you're squatting? Sure.
Yeah,
but again, we wanted to have it where you could put it almost any room in the house or in a garage and still park your vehicle and not have to do any extra work or extra stuff, moving parts, pins, things like that. Just real simple.
Yeah, I actually was thinking about this. It's very unconventional thought process, but you know, we've got a lot of people. As a matter of fact, most of our people at Barbell Logic Online Coaching who don't train at home now and train at gyms live in cities. and they often will live in apartments. And so they don't really have an option for a home gym in an apartment. But I actually think this gives you a certainly a temporary option, even in an apartment, right? You can lay some horizontal studs across the wall and make sure those are driven into the studs. And you could actually put this in your dining room, and it doesn't take up much space, and it would allow you to train even in a small, a lot of these like micro apartment, the 500 square foot apartment. You've probably got a spot on the wall that you can put these where it sticks out a little more than a foot. And with a barbell with a limpet plates on, it's only going to be an additional 9 inches. So you're talking about less than 2 feet sticking out of the wall, even with weight on the bar. So it's pretty tight. It's very, very efficient.
You're going to have to stand somewhere anyway, so you're going to have a little bit of space there to start.
That's right. So awesome rack. Comes in a few different colors, which is pretty cool as well. Just super efficient. That I love that 3 to 5 day turnaround for shipping out. You'll most people are going to get it within 7 or 8 days, I would assume. Again,
I would say so.
Based on how many hundreds of thousands of people listen to this podcast and blow the thing up, then it may push it back to 8 or 9 or 10 days. But you can get it in a hurry, and this is a great thing to have. And then I was thinking about this too. I would love to have one of these just as sort of a secondary rack, even as I go back. I've got a nice home gym. I'm like you. I've got a big, super nice rack and everything that I need. But there are times when it would be really nice to have a little secondary rack on a sidewall. And so this brings a lot of versatility as well. For me, I have my home gym is in a large bedroom in my house, but I have some stuff out in my garage. I've got a reverse hyper out in my garage, a lat pull down machine, some of those things. And this would be a great rack to stick in my garage, as well as just a secondary rack to have when the weather's nice and I don't want to train in a bedroom. It's perfect. Again, an outdoor, you can mount it outdoor to any myriad of things, including trees, which is pretty cool. And it's the right time of year for that, right? So it's pretty nice in most of the 48 states right now to be able to go outside and train.
It's pretty cool. We have a gym outside at our farm, and we also have another little strongman area out at HQ. And this is the perfect time to go outside and train. And we do. I'm a big outdoorsman, so I do a lot of lift, run, and shooting. And so, tying that all in together, and literally when we bolted it to the racks the other day, we just literally walked through the woods until we smashed the bar up against it. Said, okay, these trees are roughly the right width, and with our ratchet, with our little gun, zip, 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 they're in the tree, and we were training, and that rack is still sitting out in the woods right now.
Yeah, super cool. And I'm sure will hold up for years that you've got the nice powder coat on it, right? I mean, so it's going to...
Yeah. Is it going to be perfect? No. I mean, if people have asked you, what do you do if you leave outside? I don't know. You leave something, you leave a lawnmower outside, it's painted, it's metal, it's going to get some rust
on it. Of course.
It just will. But again, it's a $350 rack. It's a wartime solution. And really, I want people to buy them if they want to help out and if it'll help them. But, this isn't about selling racks.
That's right.
This is about hopefully people that I'm friends with or not friends with. And just, if you're into training and really live that strong lifestyle, then I respect you. And I'd hate for someone to not have an option to train. Because training has done so much in my life. I made my life under a barbell.
Yep.
So, I think we've been extremely blessed with being successful. And if we could turn that into putting back into the community, whether we make money off it or not, I think it's the right thing.
Well, and I think that's that's the best part of this whole thing is when you said, look, we're going to take the net profits and we're going to donate them to the fight. Then, you put your money where your mouth is. It's like, hey, you would love to sell 5,000 of these things because it helps the fight, not because you're just not going to put any money in your pocket. You guys are going to recoup your costs and that's it.
Because now it's taken away labor. And
sure.
We kind of created a monster a little bit, but hey, if I have to get local, if we tap out our machinery and I have to get local other businesses with lasers and benders and get them involved in making it, well, great. Guess what we just did? We just poured into the local economy even more and maybe helped the local struggling business. That's the stage two. If we have to, we've already looked at that and, maybe we hopefully or not hopefully it'll happen. Who knows? It's really we're early on in the fight right now.
It was a great idea. I'm glad that you guys did it. Let's send people to the right spot. So if you go to sorinex.com, that's sorinex.com. The off the grid rack is right there on the homepage. We don't even need to send them to a subdirect. You'll see it right there. It's up front, close and personal. And you can order that from Sorinex. And for those of you guys that have heard, and most of you guys know, you probably had an ad at the beginning of this podcast, we have a sale right now. It's 50% off your first month of online coaching at Barbell Logic. And we'll send you a $100 gift card to Sorinex. So if you want to use this, like the you said, it's $349. The shipping is $99. So we'll cover the shipping. If you sign up for online coaching, we'll cover the shipping. We'll send it to you digital so you get it instantly. So you can send it. We can use it immediately at Sorinex. Get that thing ordered. And within a week, you could be training on solid equipment with a top-notch strength and conditioning coach at Barbell Logic. And so again, for us, same sort of thing. We've been very careful not to try to prey on the fact that many people are training at home. We've been careful with running deals and stuff. You see these people on Instagram and it's like, use discount code Corona, or like, we're not doing that shit. That bothers me. We don't do that at all. You can go to barbellogic.com. The discount code is actually April 20, and that will immediately save you 50% off your first month. And all you have to do in the notes is write Sorinex, and we'll send you a Sorinex $100 gift card right away. Bert, dude, thank you so much for doing this. I appreciate what you've done for the community, not just from an equipment standpoint, but you've been very active in supporting the strength community over the years. A lot of our good friends, you've got great friendships with Coop and with Brett McKay and Ryan Mickler and Brandon Lilly and guys that are friends of us and friends of the show. And so we're thankful that we share a lot of the same values. And so it's been nice.
It's awesome to get to talk with you and meet you. And thanks for having me on. And
of course,
I love what you guys are doing. And just simply the name of what you guys are doing, Barbell Logic. I mean, let's really just boil it down to that.
That's right.
Whether that's the design of the off-grid rack or training, it's all Barbell Logic. And we know we need to get under the barbell and get some work done. So
that's right.
Kudos to you for what you've built as well.
Thanks, dude. Simple, hard, effective. That's what works. And that's what's great about this rack. It fits exactly what we do. Simple design, heavy duty. It's going to be super effective. Get the job done right now while you're stuck at home. Go to Sorinex.com and pick it up and use discount code April20 at April20 at barbelllogic.com for online coaching. Man, I love it. Thanks for doing this thing. I know you've got a busy weekend. You're like the bankers right now. They're trying to like process all this stuff. I know you're not working Monday through Friday right now. I know it's 7 days a week.
No.
Knocking
today,
this stuff out.
Today's, if you're awake, you're working. But
that's
today
right.
is my son's fourth birthday.
Happy birthday.
He takes priority. So we're going to take him fishing. He wanted to go fishing for his birthday. We're going to have hopefully if we get lucky, we'll do a fish fry. And
Beautiful. That's
the priority.
What are you fishing for? What kind of fish?
The bluegill and bass. Okay. We have a little pond and he caught his first fish 2 days ago. And so he's super amped about it. And
that's
so
awesome.
When we hang up, I'm going to take a quick workout and then go to the house and pack up fishing.
Love it. Is he doing like a little Zebco 33 with a bobber or something?
Yeah,
is that what he's doing?
I got him a little tackle box and fishing rod for his birthday.
I love it, man.
He'll be super pumped.
That was what I did with my pops.
It's kind of funny. Side note, I got him. He wants me to tell him a fishing story every night before he goes to bed. So I was running out of fishing stories. So I gave him a Cliff Notes version of The Old Man and the Sea. And he has now fallen in love with it. So I have a 3-year-old, as you know, he's 4 today, but a 3-year-old who is a Hemingway fan and wants to watch Old Man on the Sea on YouTube all the time. So that's pretty
cool. Oddly enough, my 15-year-old daughter right now is reading that for school. And I remember reading it when I was, I love it. And I was like, so I asked her, I said, have you done any research on the guy that wrote this book? And she's like, huh? I was like, do you know who Ernest Hemingway is? And she's like, huh? I was like, hold on. We got some stories now. Like this guy was a badass. Like he liked to get in fights and drink absinthe. And he was, he was crazy. And so
he was certainly the art of manliness.
That's exactly right. Before it was cool. That guy was, he was nuts. So dude, thanks again for being on the show. Happy birthday to your kiddo. Go enjoy your family. And you guys go support Sorinex and their fight against COVID-19. Thank you for listening. We will see you in a few days.
Thanks a ton.